Okay, so let's start this chapter now. Newton's laws of motion. It's the fifth chapter in H.C. Verma, page number 64. Now talk about here few things. That is Newton's first law. Second law. And third law. You remember the statements of these laws? Now let me tell you.
Now you have to know the statements of these laws.
Every body continues to remain in the state of rest or of uniform motion unless and until it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. Okay, this law is also called as law of inertia. Law of inertia. What is the inertia? Inertia is the tendency of the body to remain in the state of rest or of uniform motion unless and until it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. Every body tries to remain in the same state of rest or of uniform motion. If I keep it like this, it will remain like this for years together. If I don't apply any force, if I am applying some unbalanced force on it, then it will move. If I am applying some unbalanced force, balanced force, the weight is balanced by this force. But if this upward force is more than the weight, then it will get lifted. There is a friction between the two surfaces. If I am applying very little force, it's not moving. Because the friction is trying to balance this. But if I apply the force which is more than the balancing force of friction, then it will start moving. So everybody continues to remain in the same state of rest or of uniform motion. If I get a ball and make it roll like this and there is no friction, then it will go on rolling like that forever. Okay? So everybody continues to remain in the state of rest or of uniform motion until and unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. This law is also called as law of inertia. I recommend you to learn this law while coming in the next lecture. All the three laws. I recommend. You tell me the first law and second law, I will tell you the third law because it is very simple. To every action there is equal and opposite reaction. I will never ask this law. I will never ever ask this law because everybody knows this. So even who is not studying science, he knows Newton's third law, action reaction. So I will not ask that. I will ask the second law. Rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the force applied and the change in the displacement takes place in the direction of the force applied. These are the two laws which I recommend to recall, learn, read, because you have studied these laws in right in 9th standard. So these are needed now. So they say Newton's laws are valid only for inertial frame of reference. Inertial frame of reference. Now let us understand what is meant by the frame of reference and what is inertial frame of reference.
You will understand this now. Okay?
To understand the frames of reference, I will consider a railway station. Suppose there is a railway station and on that railway station, on platform number 1, there is a box. A stationary box is lying. On platform number 2, there is a train and this train is stationary train. In that a person is there, person A. There is on platform number 3, there is one more train. This train is moving with uniform velocity. V. There is a person in that train, V. On the next platform, there is another train which is moving with constant acceleration, A. Then the person in that person is C. Okay? I want to know what is the status of this box from A's, B's and C's perspective. This is a stationary train. So from A's point of view, the box is stationary. Okay? From B's point of view, from B, person B's point of view, the person B is moving in that direction. But what he will be seeing?
Box.
He sees that box is moving in the opposite direction with velocity.
Uniform velocity.
With uniform velocity. Yes or no?
Yes.
But is it the fact?
No.
This is an illusion. And from C's point of view, from the person C's point of view,
box.
What happens to the box? The box is moving in this direction with certain acceleration, A, constant acceleration.
Yes.
Right now?
Yes.
This is from C's point of view. And this is from B's point of view, B's perspective. I hope you understand that. Right now?
Yes.
Now, the first two frames of references, they are called as stationary or fixed frame of reference. Fixed frame of reference, or it is also called as inertial frame of reference. Inertial frame of reference, the first two. Which are those? Those are the ones which are either stationary or moving with uniform velocity. And this third case is called as non-inertial frame of reference. Non-inertial or accelerated frame of reference. Accelerated frame of reference. Frame of reference. Now what is happening here, I'll tell you. From C's perspective, from C's point of view, there is an acceleration. So there is a mass and there is an acceleration. That means there is a force applied on this according to this C. And because of this force, which is an unbalanced force, this box is moving in that direction with acceleration A. This is what is happening from C's point of view. But is it a fact? No, it's not a fact. It is an illusion. It is a false thing. Isn't it? Now, why is this happening? Why is this happening because of C? Because C himself is sitting in the frame which is already moving. Isn't it?
Yes.
He is sitting in the frame of reference, which frame of reference is already moving with certain acceleration. This frame of reference is called as non-inertial or accelerated frame of reference.
Yes.
So this is a pseudo force, which is a false force. This is an unreal force, which comes into the picture. And this force is there because of the non-inertial frame of reference. This force is called as a pseudo force. This is called an unreal force. This is called as a false force, which comes into the picture because of the non-inertial frame of reference. This kind of force is not coming into the picture for the fixed frame of reference. Is this clear? So they say that Newton's laws are valid only for inertial frame of reference, matlab fixed frame of reference. Yahan par hum Newton's ke laws apply kar sakte hain bina feature. We can directly apply the laws. But to apply these Newton's laws of motion for the non-inertial frame of reference, we have to consider an imaginary force there, which automatically comes into the picture, what we can see here.
Yes.
Right? Because when you are looking at it from C's perspective, C is not moving, but the box is moving in the opposite direction with certain acceleration. There is a mass, there is an acceleration, but there has to be the force. Is this clear? So this is a very simple and lucid explanation for the frame of reference. And they say that Newton's laws of motion are applicable only for the fixed or inertial frame of reference. They are not applicable to non-inertial frame of reference. But they can be applied to the non-inertial frame of reference by applying
a suitable pseudo or unreal force. Please keep this in mind. Is this clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is the boy who is carrying certain load on his head. Let us say W is the weight of the person and W dash is the weight of this boy. Okay? And so, and let us say the normal reaction over here is N. And यहाँ का जो normal reaction होगा इसका वो कितना होगा? Normal reaction here is N dash. Let us say. So now tell me one by one. N dash or M1 dash, whatever.
M1.
M1 dash. Okay. So boy, if I am considering the boy here, what are the forces and what is the nature of this force or what is the direction of this force? First of all, this boy's weight is going to act in the downward direction. So if I consider this boy first, so this is the boy. So boy will be acted upon by what all forces? I can ask you. What are the forces which are acted upon by on this boy? So first of all, its weight will be acting vertically downwards from the center of gravity. So the weight. And this weight is acting in the downward direction. This weight is acted upon by earth.
Yes.
Right, no?
Yes.
What is the next force?
Weight of the shoulder.
To every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. So by the floor. So the floor is giving some force there, which is N, and this is acting in the upward direction. Right? Isn't it? And what else?
And the weight of the stone.
Weight of the stone. Yeah. So the weight of the stone matlab yaha par actually this stone is going to give some reaction here. Like this. Are you understanding that? So this stone or whatever, this will be giving some normal reaction in the downward direction, I would say. Barabar hai kya? This will be giving the normal reaction in the downward direction. This is when the system is buoy under, the system is buoy. System under consideration is buoy. Is this okay? Right now? Okay. Now if I say the system under consideration is the stone, I want to know what is happening to this stone now. If I am considering this stone as the body under consideration, what all forces are acting on this?
Uska
weight, which is acting in the downward direction, which is equal to W dash. Isn't it?
Yes.
So this earth is putting some weight there, which is in the downward direction. And
normal reaction
by the boy. By the boy, that's it. And the normal reaction, so this normal reaction is going to act here itself. Yeah. I'll call this as N1 dash. This is by the boy. This is N1 dash and it is in the upward direction. Now total system is in equilibrium. So total system is in equilibrium, but there is no acceleration. That means downward force is equal to upward force. That means N1 dash is equal to W dash. You understand that?
Yes.
And then here I can say that this is practically equal to W dash, magnitude wise. Right now? मैग्नीट्यूड वाइज. सो यहाँ पर क्या क्या एक्ट कर रहा है? यहाँ पर या ये है n और दिस इज बाय n1 डैश. बराबर है? सो यहाँ का टोटल नॉर्मल रिएक्शन कितना होगा? इफ आई से द वेट ऑफ द बॉय इज 100 न्यूटन एंड दिस इज से 30 न्यूटन, देन व्हाट इज द टोटल नॉर्मल रिएक्शन बाय द फ्लो?
130.
Why? Because it has to support both of this. Is that understood?
Yes.
Is this clear?
Yes.
So this will be totally 130 newton. Any doubts about that?
No.
This is very important. So suppose there is one diagram. See, this is the string. This string is supporting mass capital M. There is a point A. Okay, there is point A. They say mass of the part of the string below A. Mass
मास ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग, पार्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग बिलो ए इज इक्वल टू एम. फाइंड टेंशन इन द स्ट्रिंग एट द लोअर एंड एंड एट ए. फाइंड टेंशन इन द स्ट्रिंग एट लोअर एंड एंड एट ए. डिड यू गेट द क्वेश्चन? दिस इज पॉइंट ए, दिस इज पॉइंट ए एंड दे से दैट this mass, this part of the string below A has got mass small m. So what is the tension at the lower end? Tension at the lower end matlab they want tension at this point B, tension at B, and then they want tension at A. So if I want tension at B, I will draw the free body diagram of point B. Free body diagram of point B, FBD, free body diagram. Yes. So if I consider point B, tell me what are the forces acting on this?
The weight of the M.
Yeah, so this weight is W and that is equal to capital M into G. And, but it is not falling down, it is not accelerated. It is balanced by something in the acting in the upward direction. What is that something? It is acted upon by the tension here. So there is a tension which is acting in the upward direction. And this is the tension at B. This is the tension at B. So both are balancing each other.
Yes.
And therefore upward force equal to downward force. So what is the tension at point B? It is equal to mg. Is this clear?
Mm.
Okay? Mm. Similarly, if I want, so this is taken care of. Now I want tension at A. So I will draw the free body diagram of point A. Point A जो है उसका free body diagram हम draw करेंगे. Now I will draw the free body diagram there. Isn't it?
Yes.
So what all forces are acting here?
Tension.
So what I'll say here? Which all forces are acting here? I would say the tension, but this is pulled down by a few things. What are those two things? It is weight of this string, that is mg.
Yes.
And also this weight is pulled down by this.
That's m.
And this is mg also. But it is supported in the upward direction by the tension. And this tension is acting in the upward direction. This is tension A. But it is not falling down. So the support force is balancing these two downward forces. So what is the tension at A is equal to mg plus mg, that is equal to m plus m into g. I hope this is clear to you. Is this okay? Alright?
This is the second law.
Newton's second law. I did it. Rate of change of linear momentum is directly proportional to the applied force. And displacement takes place in the direction of applied force.
Yes.
Now let us say that M is the particle mass. This is the particle which is having mass M. It is moving with certain velocity. Kitna? V. Okay? Then what happens is we apply certain force on this. Certain force is applied on this. Because of which it is found that after some time its velocity increases to V. Okay? The time duration in this is t. Okay? So first of all, what is meant by linear momentum? What is initial linear momentum? What is initial? This is initial velocity, final velocity, mass, time and the force applied. Isn't it? So what is initial linear momentum? What is this?
लीनियर मोमेंटम इज नथिंग बट मास इनटू द वेलोसिटी.
लीनियर मोमेंटम.
ओके, सो व्हाट विल बी द फाइनल लीनियर मोमेंटम?
mv.
फाइनल माइनस इनिशियल, दैट इज नथिंग बट द चेंज इन लीनियर मोमेंटम. चेंज इन लीनियर मोमेंटम, हाउ इट इज
mv m ब्रैकेट v.
करेक्ट, mv माइनस, है ना? Now, what will be the rate of change of linear momentum?
Upon t.
Which? Rate of change, that is upon t. Right? So, let me calculate this rate of change of linear momentum. Kya hota hai? Now, I think you know that v is equal to u plus a t.
Yes.
But the v minus u is equal to a t. But the v minus u upon t is equal to a. You know this? What is this?
Okay.
This is equal to m into a. But that is, what is this? This is nothing, f is equal to m a. So rate of change of linear momentum is not proportional to, but it is equal to. हम इसको बोल रहे हैं proportional to, directly proportional to. अरे बाबा इसको direct बोलो equal to. Is equal to that way. Newton ने सोचा था it is directly proportional to, but actually it is equal to. Do you understand?
Yes.
Well, this is the explanation of Newton's second law of motion, which actually says F is equal to ma. F is equal to ma. Have you understood the explanation, the breakup of Newton's second law?
Yes.
Is this okay? Any doubts about that?